It has been a very busy week at Parliament as the committee intensified scrutiny into ministerial policy statements of different ministries, departments and agencies. The Health Committee, Committee of Finance among others, had the longest week meeting over three entities a day. The probe into mismanagement of relief items meant for Karamoja has headlined parliamentary business this week. Chaired by Jessica Ababiku, the Juman Woman Member of Parliament, the committee set a precedent of interrogating the Vice President, Jessica Alupo, Prime Minister, Remina Nabanja, and the Deputy Third Prime Minister, Rukia Isanga Nakadama, over a single inquiry. The three, among others, admitted benefiting from the iron sheet bonanza.
I got only 500 iron sheets for Kakumiro under our ledger, and Kakumiro lies under Bunyoro. Really? Even other members of parliament from my districts, from my district and the other districts under Bunyoro got iron sheets and we distributed it to the vulnerable in our area.
Is it true that I got iron sheets from the Prime Minister's office in financial year 2022-2023?
Yes.
Why did they take the iron sheets in those areas which I have named? Did I get the iron sheets physically? No. I did not even see them, but I have seen pictures of those roofed areas, which I have not even visited.
I cannot say that I will buy because I did not take to roof my house. I took iron sheets to government institutions.
The committee also worsened troubles of the embattled Minister of Karamoja Affairs, Mary Goretti Kitutu, as it handed her to police to further management after the minister concealed information and also declined to take oath of truth.
If you are not ready to do it, please... We shall not continue with you, but CID, we request that she make statement on behalf of this committee on the following. One, on the iron sheets taken to Manafa.
Kosase also put National Water and Sewage Corporation to light and exposed government entities which are defaulting on water bills. It was discovered that ministries, departments and agencies have outstanding arrears of unpaid water bills amounting to 70 billion shillings, which has been accruing since 13 months ago.
So defense, 27.5 billion.
Come again?
27.5 billion.
That's Minister of Defense.
Minister of Defense.
27.5 billion.
Minister of Energy, 176.6 million.
We get the list. I'm having reliable information that even among the debtors, State House is among. So my concern is that, yes, and every time they are asking for supplementary, my biggest concern is maybe doctor is protecting the image of the state. Otherwise, there are no reasons to why we cannot be furnished with the list of debtors, even if State House is there. This average rate of recovery is going to make us hide those who have been accumulating bills for many years. So my request is that for these specific big bills, let's get the specifics.
Absence of ministers from parliamentary sittings has been another major story that came out of parliament this week. The deputy speaker, Thomas Tayewa, was disappointed on Wednesday to enter parliament and only found two ministers on the front bench. The house resolved to name and shame ministers who snub house sittings.
I'm going to be getting the rota for that day. When I reach here, I start calling. I say, you submitted the rota as a ministry on this day. The Honorable so-and-so, you're the one who is supposed to be here.
The week climaxed with chaotic scenes on the floor of the House as MPs rejected passing of the 2.9 trillion supplementary budget. MPs opposed circumstances under which the government allocated billions of money to Munyonyo Commonwealth Resort, Atiak Sugar Factory, and Abubakar Technical Services, which are private companies.
These issues come only when they are unexpected. You even made your case worse.
3% of the budget and come to Parliament for retrospective approval. We are going to remove it.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.